أرحبه أحنعه وختم على الشعراء. كذا أحباب طه ربيع فيه مولد من تسامى على الأكوان وهي به تباهى فنور كون الأكوان منه فهو أصل لذا أمسى أبا لذا يا سيدي إمام خالد لذا حق الحناء لبنت وهب متى حملت ومظفرة حباها يا سيدي متى حملته رسل أتوها تبشرها كذا الأملاك جاء
سبحان الله
متى حملته رسل أتوها تبشرها بشراك آمينة بشراك
سبحان الله
بشراك أم الخير بشراك بشراك آمينة بشراك بشراك أم الخير بشراك متى حملته رسل أتوها تبشرها كذا الأملاك جاء كذا إبراهيم الغوصنيس ندل حاج هذا يحنعها خصوصا لو رآها الله يا الله الله يا الله في سبول الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله عليه السلام الله The Honorable Sheikh al-Islam Imam keep it this way it's going to be a little 5 minutes heart message
MashaAllah
Honorable Sheikh al-Islam Imam Ali my Mawlana
Sheikh Mani
Sheikh
Munir
and Sidi Abdullah, Mashayukhs, Ulama, brothers, Ulama, and students of Maulanas, and of course the host family, Imtiaz and Irfan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I am a little bit overwhelmed with intoxication. I would wish I could drink all the wine that the world has today so that I'll just be boozed and lose my insanity just for the love of Rasulullah. I wish I could drink all the wine. And those of you looking at us and listening to us, I repeat, I wish I could drink all the wine until there is no drop of wine for anybody to drink. Just out of mental derangement and overwhelming insanity for the love of Rasulullah. And I would love Allah to burn me in hell for the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Did you hear what I said? I said, I would love Allah to burn me in Jahannam for the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Have you ever heard anybody say that? I repeat, I would love Allah to burn me in Jahannam for the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The whole universe was created for the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jannah that you're looking for was created for the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jahannam was created for the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Oh, you don't know that? Hello? That one you kept quiet. Now listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maulana has given me 5 minutes. It ain't gonna be the 5 minutes of Leicester. It's gonna be the 5 minutes of Chicago. Or Accra, Ghana. Or anywhere in Africa. No, because I'm a Hyderabadi.
Originally,
and then I changed my nationality to Punjabi.
That's even better.
And I became a Pathan. And then later on, I became a Chaudhary. And I became
Gujarati.
Gujarati. And don't forget, Hyderabadi as well.
Subhanallah.
And then Bengali.
Subhanallah.
And then Kashmiri.
Subhanallah.
And then all of a sudden I became a British also. Listen to what Allah has to say. I am inviting all the ulamas who are watching this that there is a very insane, crazy person worse than Majnun, who had come from America, but I'm not from America. I'm originally kind of, by Allah's will, born in Ghana. But I always feel I'm Indo-Pakistani because they are the only people who are in the forefront celebrating Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's why I became overwhelmingly filled with the Holy Ghost, Islamic Holy Ghost. And then I sang for the first time in Urdu. Bear is gonna be.
Subhanallah.
Bukhari. Bukhari nahi aati. Bukharata.
Subhanallah.
Ya Rasulullah, mujhe tumse mohabbat ke magar me se nahi sakta. Listen to what Allah said. You, the ulamas of Islam all over the world, you have failed to show us who is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have failed to honor the one for whom we are all created. Is it true that is for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we are all created? Hello? Is it true?
Yes.
Are you alive?
Yes.
Is it true?
Yes.
That it is because of him that all of us are created, is that right?
Yes.
And is it true that he was a human being? Hello?
Yes.
Say yes.
Yes.
Tell me yes.
Yes.
That's what they say. It's in the Holy Quran. Allah says, Qul innama ana basharun mithlukum yuha ilayya annama ilahukum ilahun. Say, Prophet Muhammad, to them, because they don't know you, say to them that inni ana basharun mithlukum. Who told him to say that? Rasulullah didn't say that. Allah is the one who said, you say that. That I, Allah's one, said you should say that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never had intention to say that. Allah is the one who told him, Qul, say, Inni ana basharun mislukum, I'm a human being that looks like you. But the ulamas did not understand this language. Maulana was speaking and explaining the Arabic grammatically. Listen, mithlu doesn't mean that he was a human being. Allah used the term what? Mithlu. Mim, fa, wala, mithlukum. That looks like you. But does he mean that like you?
Like you. Yes.
Yes.
Hello?
Subhanallah.
Now listen to English. From Arabic to English. Remember, Allah said to, through Malaika Jibreel, alayhi salatu wasalam, to Nana Maryam. Allah says to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Al-Maryam, he says, فَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا رُوحَنَا فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا. And I send the Malaika Jibreel to her, Nana Maryam. And then he came to Nana Maryam like what? A human being. Like a full-fledged what? Mithla. Fatamathala.
Like.
Laha. Basharan. Sawiyan. Was he a human being?
No.
Hello?
No.
But Allah says, Fatamathala laha. And he appeared mithla. Basharan. Sawiyan. That looked like a human being, full-fledged human being. Did that mean that Malaika Jibreel was a human being?
No.
But he appears like a
human.
Is that right?
Yes.
Huh? Yes. And Allah says, Qul ya Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inni ana basharun miflukum. Now do you understand?
Subhanallah.
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 Was he a human being?
No.
The hell with you if you say he was a human being. You didn't understand. It's an insult for you to bring Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam down to your men. Maulana, forgive me. I used a certain word, forgive me, but you don't forgive me. Ya Sayyidi, if he's a human being, then we should never say Muhammadur Rasulullah. If we say La ilaha illallah, we should never bring his name anywhere closer to Allah's name. Hello? Hello? Can you call Allah's name the Lord of Majesty and Glory and then mention human beings' name, attach human beings' name to Allah who is not a human being?
SubhanAllah.
Hello?
SubhanAllah.
Okay. Imam Khalid, I got 3 more minutes.
And it's increasing.
And this is Allah talking now. My beautiful Diobandi brothers and sisters. You are very beautiful. I love you. And my beautiful Brelvi brothers and sisters. I love you. We shouldn't be fighting each other. Maulud al-Nabi is not for Muslims. Muslims, assalamu alaikum, are you here? Muslims? Assalamu alaikum, Muslims?
Wa alaikum
salam. Assalamu alaikum, Muslims?
Wa alaikum salam.
Assalamu alaikum, Muslims?
Wa alaikum salam.
Listen very carefully. Maulud al-Nabi is not for you. You are Muslims, all right? And Allah is going to bless you for being Muslims. Listen to the message of Allah. Inna Allah, He Allah, the Lord Creator, originator, fashioner, sustainer of the whole universe. He, Allah, has some business to talk about. He, Allah, wants to talk about a human being who is unlike a human being. He, Allah, wants to talk about somebody so important to him.
Subhanallah.
He wants to talk about somebody so special to him.
Subhanallah.
Allah wants to talk about somebody who he made for himself.
Subhanallah.
Allah is not talking to you. And he says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Hello? He says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. He says, oh, you in whose hearts, not those who believe, no. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. You in whose hearts is already established. Iman. Firm Iman. Without any doubt. Is firm. He says, Sallu alayhi. I, Allah, I'm doing it. And all my angels. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu. Is that right?
Yes.
Yes.
Allah and all his angels are making salawat. Now, wait a minute. Why is it that this human being is so important to Allah? What kind of human being is that? A human being who eats, drinks, walks, talks, and then he worries, and then sometimes he's happy, and he has wives, and he has children. Is that right? Hello?
Yes.
How can Allah be bothered about a single creature of a human being? And then for him to say, He, Allah, we all know that it is human beings who rather glorify the master. Have you ever seen a king glorifying a servant?
No.
And putting him so important to him and to his throne? Please, come on.
No.
Have you ever seen that?
No.
But this is a servant of a difference. Muhammad al-Bashar wala kal-Bashar bal huwa kal yaqut bayna al-hajar. If you don't know Prophet Muhammad, Muhammad is a human being, but he is not like any human being. But he is like that ruby, that jewel, which is intertwined between the gold ore. Now, let's go to the Quran. Please, Hafazul Quran, help me. Allah wants to say, do you know Prophet Muhammad? Hello? Mawlana, Hafizahullah, Imam Khalid said, Yawm al-Qiyamah. We are waiting until Yawm al-Qiyamah to look for the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he is right. But listen to what Allah had to say. And when we go home, let us rediscover the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I want us to challenge anybody on the planet Earth who doesn't do any Mawludin Nabi and wants to condemn the Mawludin Nabi. He must be very careful, because his salat, his zakat, his fasting will take him to hell. Just because of his language. Because he doesn't know who he's talking about. Please leave the Diobandis alone. They are beautiful. And they should rather be blessed for condemning you people who do Maulud and you don't know Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you know Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you would have taken it easy. Ya Ikraf al-Din, this is Prophet Muhammad. That is why we're doing that. We just love him. Don't condemn him. Don't condemn them. If they condemn him for love, have you ever seen you have a woman or a man, a woman has a man. You love your woman so much. and then somebody tells you your woman is ugly, would you worry about that? Hello? Have you ever fallen in love before? Here is a woman, I love her so much. And just as I said, we gay to Muse, Mahabatike, Magari me say, Nahi Sakata. And somebody comes to tell you, that woman you're singing about, she is very ugly. Would you care about that? Hello?
No.
Majnun doesn't care. He doesn't give a damn about what you say for his love for Layla. Does he care?
Yeah.
No, you shouldn't care. But if you worry about anybody who's condemning you for your craziness of Layla, then you are not worthy of being Majnun. Do you understand me?
Yes.
We talk about ishq nabi. It means you are insane and crazy about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You don't worry about nobody. When the more they condemn you, the more your love increases. Is that right?
Yes.
Because the more they attack you, the more your iman increases. Is that right? Listen to Allah says, asking us question and then I shut up. And that will take another 1 minute. He says, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. إذا الشمس كورت
سبحان الله
وإذا النجوم انكدرت
سبحان الله
وإذا الجبال سيرت
سبحان الله
وإذا العشار عطلت
سبحان الله
وإذا الوحوش I have to obey Imam's guidance. This will take us, wallahi, summa billahi al-azim, one whole year, and we have not exhausted what Allah is talking here. Allah wants to show us, why do you worry yourself? Do you know Prophet Muhammad? Allah says, now wait a minute, I am going to cause the sun, which is over 360,000 times more massive than the Jupiter. And the Jupiter is 1,012 times more massive than the planet Earth. Allah says, I'm going to destroy it. And I'm going to destroy all the planets. I'm going to destroy all the galaxies. Do you know Prophet Muhammad? I'm going to destroy all of this in order to show you who is Prophet Muhammad. Do you know him? And he says, Allah, I am going to destroy all the stars and the galaxies, trillions that you see all over the universe. I'm going to destroy all of them, get them all discarded and obliterated. And he asks a question in between. Do you know Prophet Muhammad? He says, what is al-bihar sujirat? And where all the oceans of the whole universe are evaporated into nothingness, like bubbles. Do you know Prophet Muhammad? Come on, answer. Do you know Prophet Muhammad? And up until when he says, علمت نفس ما أحضرت. And then he will do all of this until every human being, every soul will realize that that day you're coming to be in something. Things you have done, that day you know its value. Still waiting to know who is Prophet Muhammad. And he said, what is that suhuf nushirat? All of a sudden, let me cut it. He said, innahu laqawlu rasulin kareem. He will do all of this before you will come to know even the value of the Quran, then this statement is not a last statement. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Hey, trouble. He says, innahu, instead of Allah says, this is my statement, he says, innahu laqawlu rasulin kareem. You that day know that this Quran is truly Allah has chosen Prophet Muhammad only to express those words. But they are whose words? Hello? Whose words are they? Come on, whose words are they? Did you hear Allah speaking? Hello? Did you hear Allah speaking? Who did we hear speaking? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That means Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah spoke through Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Everything he said, Allah said. And then he is a Rasul that you'll never know until that day. And he says, Rasulin Kareem, the most honorable messenger to Allah, not to you. And he said what? Zi Quwwa, the one who is full of super power. America, my country. My beautiful America claims to be the remaining superpower.
You didn't say nothing.
My country, Obama needs to know this. My president, beautiful president, hardworking president, Obama, you need to know this. When you get off from that seat from the White House, you're gonna come to the Black House. Where you're gonna learn some few things about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah said, Zikuwa, Allah is the supreme power. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the super power. He said,
Allah.
He said, Muta'in Tamma. I mean, he said, you must have to obey Rasulullah
sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Do you have to obey a human being? Only Allah, is that right? But Allah says, Muta'in Tamma. I mean, you must obey him. And if you don't obey him, you will never see Jannah. The only day you will get the security. Thamma Amin means he is trustworthy, and if you have faith and honor and hold him in high esteem, you that day you are guaranteed of Allah's blessing.
SubhanAllah.
It is for him. Allah says, if you do one salawat to him, or for Muhammad, Allah said, I, Allah, because you said one salawat to Rasulullah, I, Allah, I guarantee you, I, Allah, will do for you 10 times.
SubhanAllah.
Is he a human being? Hello?
No.
Hello?
No.
My Gujarati and Hyderabadi brothers. Is he a human being?
No.
You who do not know Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and have reduced him to nothing, I pray Allah forgive us and forgive you.
Amen.
Because it's our duty to learn to know Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to impart the love of him. The topic I'm dealing with, this is a topic I want to bring to the whole Muslim world. It's a challenge.
SubhanAllah.
Let's rediscover who is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let, because Allah says, Alam nashrah laka sadrak wa wada'na 'anka wizrak ya Rasulullah alladhi anqadha dhahrak wa rafa'na laka dhikrak wa rafa'na
laka dhikrak.
Allah has to exalt him.
SubhanAllah.
Does he need your exaltation?
No.
Does he need your honor?
No.
Hello?
No.
He says, wa rafa'na laka
dhikrak.
Zikran.
I, Allah, I have exalted you, Prophet Muhammad, my messenger, my beloved. I, Allah, I have exalted you.
SubhanAllah.
To the extent that nobody in the entire creation ever will ever be honored like you, because I put your name to my name only. Your shahada is totally useless unless it comes with the name of Prophet Muhammad. Your salat is absolutely invalid, nullified, completely useless unless you mention the name of Prophet Muhammad. And you have to mention his name attached to Allah's name. In your salat, you're making maulud. Whether you know about it or you don't know about it, you are performing maulud in your salat. Whether you like it or not, when you say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Do you have to say that one time?
Twice.
You said Allah twice, is that right? You must say Prophet Muhammad two times.
SubhanAllah.
You mention Allah two times? You must mention Prophet Muhammad two times.
SubhanAllah.
وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. Is that right? And when we say يا رسول الله, then you curse us out. I love your curse. It makes me feel loved. And then you say قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. Is that right? And then in the tashahud, if you don't do maulud, you've been doing ta'zim every day in your salat. Before you say salam alaikum, you have to do ta'zim to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After you say attahiyatu lillah wa tayyibatu salawat, assalamu alayka, assalamu alayka, assalamu alayka, assalamu alayka, assalamu alayka. That place where you say Ayyuhan Nabi, you can say Ayyuhan Rasul. You can even use Ayyuhan Habib, Habibullah, and it's correct. For it is Muhammadun Rasulullah.
SubhanAllah.
Is that right?
Yes.
It is Muhammadun Rasulullah. So you ought to say, Assalamu alayka, Ayyuhan Rasul. If you say that, you are correct. Tell everybody, I said that. And if you say, Bida, I said, that is good. That is a good Bida. And I want to go to hell for that good Bida. I said, Ayyuhan Rasul. It is in the Quran. Is that right? Allah has said, يا أيها النبي لما تحرم ما أحل الله لك تبتغي مرضات أزواجك. I'm finishing now because Maulana has been very patient enough. My 10 minutes or 15 minutes is gone and another 30 minutes was added. Don't want to go any further. But Maulana Sheikh Al-Murshidi wa Sayyidi, from the bottom of my heart, we need to put up a talk with the whole Muslim world. Either on Ummah TV, Takbir TV, or Noor TV, or every TV. I'd rather want BBC, CNN, Al Jazeera, NBC, Fox or Lion or Elephant TV. And we come, let us talk. When they make nonsense and mockery of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I don't condemn them, no. Denmark, you good. I'm an artist too. I can paint like Leonardo da Vinci. I'm serious.
I won the first prize in painting, fine arts, in 1972 when I was very young. From imagination, I painted a picture depicting compassion to the human, compassion to all living creatures. The number one, the whole of Africa, and it was organized by Netherlands. You should have left me alone with that guy in from Denmark and tell them that we got some painter. And he said, a very crazy man from Africa. And he's American now, from Chicago. And he paints like Van Gogh or Salvador Dali. And then I'll paint him looking so good. It's a challenge. It's an artistic talk. But ours is... Maulana Imam Wasayyidi, ours is not to condemn nobody. The tongue that praises Rasulullah will never condemn nobody. Because he doesn't have time. Because your tongue is so pure, only for Rasulullah. The tongue that glorifies and says salawat unto Rasulullah Wallahi has no time to condemn no one. No. Because it is too precious and valuable to Allah. This is the tongue only for Rasulullah. For Allah or Rasul. How do we use it, waste it, and make it contaminated by condemning somebody else? By finding someone. Do you see? Do you understand me?
Yes.
So we got work to do. We want to call Saudi Arabia. Hello, Saudi Arabia.
Yes.
I love you. I will come to Mecca not because of you. No, I have no problem with you. I don't need you. I don't need your money. I have more than what you got. And I have more than what anybody got. And that's the love for Rasulullah. That is enough for
us. Ya Rasulullah.
I want to come for Ziyara. I want you to give me the crown of Mushrikeen. I want to go to Medina only to stand at this door and say, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, here is a useless, worthless, good for nothing compared to nothing creature. For your sake, may Allah purify my heart.
Amen.
And in my heart, I don't want nothing but your love.
Subhanallah.
Kaaba is totally meaningless for me. I don't worship no stones. I don't worship no buildings. Allah has given us Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the Qibla of my heart. Do you understand me? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the Qibla of what? My heart. But Allah told us we should face, my direction is to the Qibla of Makkah. But my heart is for Rasulullah
sallallahu
alaihi wasallam.
And Allah has said, it is not righteousness to turn to the east, nor west. But Allah's Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, La yu'minu ahadukum. Brothers, you have a bigger responsibility. If you don't come better than this imam here, you have failed. You have to carry the message and make it heavier and spread. Devote your time and honor and listen to everything he gives you. And value it like gold and diamond. That is the only way you'll be successful. So, where was I? Please remind me.
La yu'minu ahadukum.
Jazakallah khair ya Mawlana. I told you I'm a crazy man. So, la yu'minu ahadukum. That's the end of my story, but never ending. La yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min nafsi. None of you is a mu'min. Even though you love, you say you love Allah too much, is that right? You are not a mu'min. Unless you love me, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, more than yourself. He didn't say Allah, he said me. We need to talk. I am finished.
Does that come
up? Abarqun bada نهو المرابع يلمع فهبني مراعا إذ يلمع البرق يدمع لمحت بوحن ويك هجت سبابة ورقراق دمعي ساءت الحي تحجع تذكر أيام الصبا وهي قد مضت ولم يق إلا لوعة وتوجع سقى الله أرضا بالمدينة إنها محط رحال فيه خرق يرقع ديار حبيب الله وهو أمينه ديار لمن تلف المرافق أجمع ديار لمن هام الفؤاد بحبه وتذكاره للقلب مرعا ومرتع صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله عليه وسلم. May Allah bless this home.
Amen.
And the inmates of this home.
Amen.
May Allah bless this ulama, the shuyukh, beautiful.
Amen.
And for them, and increase their nur of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And increase their mahabba for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Till they match us, guide us, yawm al qiyamah, and so that we will be among those who will be saying, ألا ليت شعري هل أفوز برؤيتي محيا الرسول الله ذلك بغيتي مها حب خير الخلق حبا سواه بقلب الذي أهيا وسر سناه فإن جمالا غير وجه محمد فإن جمالا غير وجه محمد نفاه جمال المصطفى ومهاه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم وعلى آله حق القدر والمقدار العظيم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على